Leaders of national dental associations from the Africa region met in Geneva from the 15th to the 18th of February to participate in a workshop organized by FDI World Dental Federation. Second in a series, this edition focused on communication, advocacy, and fundraising. We spoke to some of the participants to hear what they learned and how they'll apply it.
It's such a very wonderful event that's afforded us the opportunity of learning about communication, advocacy, and fundraising, which are key factors in the life of any association. Of course, through the courses that we went through, we're able to learn to relate with people, to learn to go out on behalf of our association with our board members as well and members, to talk about our association and then introduce our associations to other corporate bodies in the process of interacting with them to seek their support and all that. Moreover, it has afforded us the opportunity to interact with other leaders from different countries, African leaders of national dental associations. We've been able to rub minds, share ideas together, and be able to look at the ups and downs of how to manage an association. We've learned a lot. I don't know how to describe it and all that. It's giving us a leverage as African leaders to be able to move our association to the next level.
It was a very fantastic workshop, and we learned a lot about communication and advocacy and fundraising. And I will go home. I will apply these three main objectives to my work, and I hope I can change the policy of oral health in my country.
Cette excellente formation, ça va me permettre de, en rentrant, d'appliquer ce qu'on a appris aussi ici, c'est de voir, de comprendre la stratégie de la Fédération dentaire internationale et d'essayer d'appliquer sa stratégie dans mon pays.
Nous avions appris à organiser l'association au niveau 1. Au niveau 2, nous apprenons à communiquer. Nous apprenons à faire des plaidoyers et nous apprenons à rechercher le financement. Nous espérons que cette formation permettra, à travers nous, à la Fédération dentaire internationale, d'atteindre ses objectifs, qui sont de faire de bons plaidoyers pour la santé bucco-dentaire dans le monde.
One of the highly anticipated talks was from Dr. Benoît Varenne, Regional Advisor for Oral Health in the Non-Communicable Diseases Cluster at the WHO Regional Office for Africa, who revealed the upcoming Oral Health Strategy for Africa to be published in August of this year.
Alors, les associations dentaires nationales peuvent contribuer, bien évidemment, et on attend justement de leur part un soutien auprès donc des ministères de la Santé à différents niveaux. Le premier, je pense, c'est en matière de leadership et de sensibilisation auprès donc des décideurs politiques, puisque le premier objectif donc de la stratégie est justement de faire en sorte que la santé orale soit reconnue et puisse contribuer clairement au programme de lutte contre les maladies non transmissibles. Donc là, les associations dentaires nationales peuvent participer et doivent participer aux groupes de travail qui seront mis en place au niveau des ministères de la Santé pour finaliser évidemment les plans d'action ou les stratégies au niveau national et de faire en sorte qu'une partie des responsabilités pour la mise en œuvre des activités soit dédiée en partie à ces associations dentaires nationales.